Right, so this is a new update, and today we are going to see how we can draw this product or this 3D CAD inside Blender. And basically, we will use Blender 3. You can use 3.1 or 3.2. All the native tools will be used. You will use only the tools and the functions which is it has been existed in Blender. No external add-ons, so let's get started. We will make firstly the arch, so I will make an arch. I will start from a circle. This circle will be vertex, has vertex around 40. I will rotate and delete this half. Select all and move in the Z 0.1. I will select this vertex and extrude in the Z minus 0.1. GZ minus 0.1. EZ minus 0.1. And after that, we can click in this area and make the cursor to 3D cursor and extrude scale until we reach this line. And I will select this item and this item, activate snapping and move this to be here. Right, then I will extrude in the Y around 2 meters. After that, let's select this one and extrude in the X minus 3. And this one also will be extruded in X1. After that, let's make something. I will delete this face and we have a mirror, so I will delete this half, shift S cursor selected, and make the origin to the 3D cursor. After that, mirror in the Y, apply the rotation. Then we can select this one or this edge, and the cursor will be here. Assume that you want the radius to be 0.2, so we will extrude in the Y 0.2, shift S, cursor selected, and delete this vertex. It will be helpful or helper. So select this edge and Alt E to spin. Let's activate the screencast keys and Alt E spin 16. Start with 14 and 90 minus 90, and after that enable clipping and E in Y, extrude in Y. So we want some edges. Let's select this and extrude in the X or G in Y. Add loop cut here. we want 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We want 6 loops. And here also we want 6 loops. Let's fill this one. Again here, select this 2 faces and fill. Select this edge and fill. Remaining this one to be filled, and this also will be filled. So why, just one thing, we have made the symbol thread, then we can add the details at any moment. At any moment we can add the cavity here. So I will add some loop cuts here, and we need 1, 2, 3 around 7 here. Let's fill, and we don't need this one. Let's fill again. That's fine, we have made something here. Why we have used this method? Because this is the accurate method. We have made the radius to be 20 centimeter, and we will make the same here. But we can use the mirror modifier also, or because we have the same vertex, we can select this one and shift D in the X and the control MX, and let's move here. After that, let's see what number of vertex we have. We have here in the statistics, we have here 2. I will delete all these faces. Let's see, 18 and 18. Let's bridge from here or from here, it's the same. And if you want to make it perfect, you can calculate this distance from here. Length, edge length, and if we want it to be 2 meters, so we can select all and G in X 0.3. So it's now this edge is 2 meter, perfect. How we can make this hole? So select, we can use something. So let's duplicate in the Y, and we can use the boolean. Let's add a cylinder and scale. Alright, after that let's add boolean. I will save and if we hide it we have this one. I think let's see again. So we have some holes here, we should close. I select this edge and fill few times. Make sure you have the add-on which is here, F2, to be activated. And fill, let's try again. I will select some edges and scale down, and this edge also. So this is one method. As you can see, it's not perfect. We can add before move to first, and let's see the result. This is the result. You can apply the boolean, and after that. Select these edges and scale shift Z and bridge. This is one method, it may work at some times, it may work the same here. Apply to the other thing normal and here apply the normal. So this is one thing. As you can see, this also is optimized for 3D printing. You can use it for 3D printing. Right, after that we have here a circle. So this is one of the problems for using booleans. We can't add loop cut here. So how we can solve this? We can use the knife tool to add some loop cuts here, and knife tool again, loop cut, really I don't know why this has some problems here. Fill again. So I will fill these faces and add here. This is one face, so let's solve all of these vertex and fill. Alright, so in the next lesson we will add the three details which is in the above.